I've got several videos covering in real life live streaming using mobile apps like Larix Broadcaster, iRoll Pro, and now I want to introduce to you Streamcast Pro. Firstly, I'd like to give a shout out to One of a Kind for sharing it with everyone on Discord. Now at a glance, Streamcast shares a lot of visual similarities to Larix and iRoll Pro, but there's a few differences, so let's discuss some of them in today's video. Firstly, there's the cost. Streamcast and iRoll Pro are free without any limits, whereas Larix has a monthly subscription to unlock all premium features like HEVC or H.265. As for platform, Streamcast can be found on the iPhone App Store, iRoll Pro on Google Play, Larix on both. So if you've got an iPhone, there's Streamcast and Larix. For Android users, there's iRoll Pro and Larix. Maybe install Larix anyway so you have a point of comparison. FYI, I'm neutral between Android and iPhone devices. I don't love or hate one more than the other. They each serve a purpose in my daily use. So let's continue. All three apps support H.264 and SRT. You can record live streams, see your audio levels, mute, unmute the microphone, take screen caps while you're live streaming, switch from back to front cameras, and more. By the way, these are features I use all the time. Okay, so what's different for iRoll Pro? Streamcast and Larix support multi-camera capture, like picture-in-picture mode, whereas iRoll Pro does not. Strangely, Larix on Android does. The takeaway here is some features may not be available depending on the app and hardware capabilities of your specific phone model. Hopefully, iRoll Pro will add it soon for flagship devices like the S23 Ultra. Picture-in-picture mode is one of the key features I miss the most from Larix. iRoll Pro also has bonding, but maybe we'll save that for another video. Anyway, how about Larix? Recently, Larix switched to a premium model, so you're limited to 30 minutes of live streaming without a watermark. After 60 minutes, your stream will end. Also, HEVC or H.265 is a premium-only feature for Larix. And finally, Streamcast. Well, as of this video, it looks like Streamcast doesn't support overlays, and Larix and iRoll Pro, I use overlays to read chat and for stream alerts, so I know, for example, when someone has subscribed. I suppose if you have a setup like mine, your home computer can handle overlays for you, but if you're ever in a situation where you have to stream directly to a service like Twitch, you'll have to go without. In other words, your stream will look very bland or noobish, if that's a word. To be honest, I think the way Larix handles overlays is a bit of a mess, whereas I like the way Streamlabs Mobile does it. I think it's more intuitive, but a bit clunky for my big fingers. In summary, Streamcast looks like a great free alternative to Larix Broadcast if you want to live stream with your iPhone using HEVC over SRT. I'm not affiliated with any of these companies, so if you'd like to download Streamcast Pro, you'll find a download link in the description. If there's anything else you'd like to know about any of these apps, let me know in the comments so I can do a follow-up video to this one. In the meantime, check out this playlist to see what I'm currently using for IRL live streaming. See you there.